Welcome to the video, my people, and to another edition of
Vegan Meals.
If you saw my last episode of the series, you'll know that I'm a big fan of making foods that are cheap, healthy, and relatively quick to conjure up. Kind of how I like my women. Well, today is no different, except we're not going in the most healthiest route. Today we'll be making anabolic vegan sloppy joes that are heavenly anabolic. Double anabolic. Before and after. I'm gonna be honest with you guys, I've made this recipe a few times before, but it's not a staple for me. But nonetheless, it's fun to take a trip to the wild side sometimes. More on that in a bit. However, one of the main reasons I'm making this video today is because Greg Doucette already beat me to it with regard to a very similar recipe. Mr. Fake Anabolism, who has been recently humbled by his own audience due to a little controversy between him and Jeffrey Schofield. Watch the video up above if you want to see more details in regards to that. But nonetheless, as a side note, Greg has been taking a much more level-headed approach when engaging with his audience and people who have recently critiqued him. He was even pretty respectful with me, even though I wasn't so respectful to him. Though it's great, it seems that Greg Doucette is taking a more level-headed approach with this, or with his engagements. I personally really couldn't give two shits, as he is still supporting animal abuse and is failing to address the issue like a man.
And guess what we're making today?
Sloppy Gregs.
And we have two versions. We have one for the animal safety people.
We have a plant-based one.
Plant-based, the people who don't want to eat meat.
What's it called? It's called Veggie Sloppy Greg's.
A Veggie Sloppy Greg sandwich. And mine is a Sloppy Greg sandwich. The regular kind using meat.
Yeah.
Meatless meat. You can choose the one you want. We're going to do both of them at the same time.
I seriously don't understand this guy. He has all the knowledge, capabilities, and money. Not like it takes that much of any of those attributes to begin with, or power to follow a vegan lifestyle, but he still promotes the use of animal products so that he can shill out his shitty cookbook. Yes, people, let society dictate your morality so that you can drone on with the rest of them, even if you know what you're doing is wrong, because, hey, there's money on the table, and if the animals have to pay for it through torture and death, so be it. Remember, everyone is doing it, so it must be right. What a great man Greg Doucette is. I swear, we have a planet of integrity lacking little pussies like Greg Doucette that really makes me want to slide into a deep depression. But then I remember I have a YouTube channel and I hope I can make a difference. So let's get this bitch rolling. Rant over. Let's start with the ingredients of this anabolic, plant-based sloppy joe. Beefless ground beef, sloppy joe sauce, and bread of your choice. Those are all the ingredients you will need for this recipe. Amazing, isn't it? I swear, let me hear just one fucker say that eating vegan or plant-based is too complicated or it takes too long. Bitch, you don't know what complicated is. You know what's complicated? Dealing with all my ex-wives and future ex-wives. It ain't easy for a pimp these days. And don't get me started on my side pieces. So the first thing that you're going to want to do with this extra complicated recipe is heat up the sauce for about 3 minutes or so. Next, you'll add the plant-based meat inside the sauce. While the plant-based meat is cooking with the sloppy joe sauce for about 3 to 5 minutes or so, you can toast your bread if you like your bread toasted. Next, serve your sloppy joe. So that's it, people. This is the dish right here. Now you'll notice I made 3 sloppy joes on 3 different types of bread to show you that you have choices in life. First here on the ciabatta bread, we have a plant-based meat sloppy joe, which is like the crazy dirty girl who you know you're gonna enjoy, but it's gonna leave you wanting coming back for more, but you're not openly gonna talk about it because it makes you feel yucky. Second here, we have a plant-based meat sloppy joe on some wheat bread, but it has some minor preservatives. Not the best thing for you, very similar to being married with a woman who has just the right amount of crazy fuck style, but eventually fucks you over by taking you to court and taking your kids away from you. Again, not the best thing for you, but it gets the job done for the meantime. And thirdly here, we have the plant-based meat sloppy Joe on some Ezekiel bread, no preservatives, no crap ingredients, all natural, just wonderful, like one of my most current ex-wives. All natural olives great, but damn, father, or rather mother time, is mean sometimes, which is why it's great to diversify your portfolio of women. Spread yourself out around, guys. Don't be greedy. So what do we do? Which one do we choose? Easy. Do them all at the same time. That way everybody gets an equal share. We'll start with the dirty girl first. Oh, yeah. We'll go with the other kind of healthier option. Give it a shot, but might fuck you over in the end.
Yes, very tasty. Not as good as that one though, but very tasty.
And now we'll go with the most stable one, the most healthiest option. No preservatives, no nothing. The Ezekiel bread biscuit or muffin, whatever you want to call this thing. Biscuit, bread thing, whatever.
Oh, yeah.
Those anabolic gains are serious.
It really is a tasty treat, whichever route you choose to go with in regards to the bread. And if you want to make it more tasty, you could add a slice of plant-based cheese. But I don't do it because a lot of those plant-based cheeses are loaded with saturated fat from coconut oil or palm oil. Not really the best thing for you. So I recommend you avoid them, like I told my ex-wife way back in the day, to avoid Charlie Sheen. By the way, she was with me before Charlie Sheen, so just so you know, just so that we're clear. Nonetheless, she didn't listen. Nonetheless, I hope you were able to take something away from this. I hope you can try this on your own. This is just another video showing that it is not hard to eat plant-based, to be a vegan. It is not difficult. So why don't you guys let me know what you guys think in the comment sections down below. As you know, I love to engage with all of you. Please know that I appreciate every single one of you. Feel free to hit the like, subscribe, and ding dong button if you haven't already. I'm the Natural Hulkster. I want to thank you all for watching, and please stay tuned for the next one.